Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So I was driving my IS250 the other day and this thing started lagging and I was like, oh crap, I think my transmission was going out because it really slowed the shift in the gear and I was getting really poor acceleration. The whole time I was driving, I drove like 10 miles before I got back home. I was concerned that one of the solenoids on the transmission was going out, which is a very common problem on this car. I got home, I plugged up TechStream and I ran the code and luckily, it's not the transmission. I didn't get any transmission codes. The only code I got was something about misfiring on cylinder one. So today we're gonna take apart that spark plug on cylinder one and see what's going on. Luckily, cylinder one is on the side that's easily accessible on the IS250. The cylinders on the bank two, which is the opposite side, are the ones that are really hard to get to because it's under the intake manifold. So this side is very easy, it's under the intake. So we'll go ahead and take a look right now and see what's going on. So on this engine, this is bank one. So these are cylinders one, three, and five. That's bank two, so that's two, four, and six. So that's how this engine is set up. So our check engine light is on bank one, cylinder one. Cylinder one is right here, it's right under the intake, and it's the easy one to get to. So I'm gonna go ahead and take that apart right now and see if there's anything wrong with the coil pack or the spark plug. And I might swap one and two to see if the problem goes to the second one, and that tells me that it's the coil pack. Bank two is a pain in the ass side on the IS250 because of the intake manifold. You can't get to the last two cylinders because of the intake manifold and the design of it, so you actually have to take this whole thing apart. But compared to bank one, where you could just take apart the intake and you have access to all three cylinders on this side. So taking out the coil pack, I noticed there was some grease and some oil on the tip, but the seal and everything looked good and everything looks good over here. So I'm not sure if I put some grease or something on my last spark plug change and maybe that's just stuff burning up, but we'll go ahead. Looking down the spark plug tube, I do see a little bit of oil down there. So I'm not sure if the spark plug came loose for some reason or some oil's coming in somehow down in there, but I'm gonna go ahead and take that spark plug out and see what's in there. I'll also take apart this second coil pack and see if the condition looks the same as this one. So it looks like both of them are covered in the same oil and sludge right in that spark plug hole. As you look down these holes, it looks like we're getting some oil blow by on the seal around the valve covers. That must be slipping down the tube and getting onto the spark plug and into the hole. So I'm gonna go ahead and just take these spark plugs out and see what they look like to see what's causing this misfire. So it looks like I think I figured out my problem. For some reason, these things were just hand tightened and then the freaking spark plugs were actually loose. So I'm gonna go ahead and re-tighten these, clean them up a little bit, and see if that fixes my problem. That's odd that these would be loose because last time I changed these, I could have sworn I tightened them like a quarter or a half turn past tight. And these things coming loose like that is very odd. So I'm gonna check that last one on this side and see if it has the same issue. So it looks like that last one is clean like it's supposed to be. So that one is obviously tight. So I'll go ahead and torque that down, make sure it's all tight, clean out these two and then put that back together. I'm assuming I must not have tightened it enough or somehow it vibrated loose. All right, got everything back together. A little pro tip when you're taking out the spark plugs or putting them back in, you wanna take that rubber piece off when you're screwing it down so that way your socket doesn't get stuck in there. You need that rubber to pull the spark plug out, but when you're putting it back in, it just gets stuck down in the cylinder, so you just wanna remove that whenever you get there. All right, we're back in the car. Let's start this up and see how it goes. Still kind of making the same noise as it was before. I'm gonna go ahead and run the codes and see if I get anything. All right, so that's a failure there. At least I figured out my spark plugs were loose. What I'm gonna try to do now, I'm gonna switch one and two on the coil packs
and see if that misfire moves. If that misfire moves, then that means there's something wrong with the coil pack and we'll have to replace that. All right, I swapped it. I kind of put everything back together, not tightened down yet, just to see what happens when I start this up again. So I started it up again. It sounds a little different than before, but we'll go ahead and run the codes in text stream and see what it gets.
So it's odd, we have a check engine light on VSC.
But then I look on here and I don't see anything on the trouble codes. This is very odd.
It sounds very weird back here and it's running very rich, like one of the cylinders is not burning.
Still getting cylinder one misfire. So there's something else wrong. I don't know if it's a spark plug or maybe the fuel injector. So I'm about to shut this down. Still no luck in swapping these coil packs. So next thing I'm gonna try to do is maybe it's a spark plug. I'll swap it from 1 to 3 to see what happens. All right, so looking at the 3 spark plugs on bank one, this is spark plug cylinder 1, 3, and 5. You can see cylinder 1, it's got some incomplete combustion. You can see the carbon and the other buildup right there on the prongs. On the other two, it looks like they've been burning pretty well because those two both kind of look the same and they've gone through the same kind of coloration. So maybe I have a bad spark plug. I'm gonna go ahead and swap all these around in just straight order. So I'm gonna move 1 to 5, 5 to 3, and then 3 to 1. And we'll see if it still misfires. All right, so I went in here and checked it again. And it looks like our misfire moved to cylinder 3, which means that it's a bad spark plug. So right now with the misfire, you can kind of hear the engine kind of making like a weird noise, like a creaking noise, like it's out of balance. So that's one of the things that you can possibly hear when you're doing this, or if you have the same code. So just to confirm, I decided to move the spark plug to cylinder 5, and now we're getting cylinder 5 misfire. So it's not the coil packs, it's obviously the spark plug. So I'm gonna go ahead and just replace that single bad spark plug. My spark plugs only have like 20, maybe 25,000 miles on them. And these are like 70,000 mile spark plugs. I replaced them back in 2017 and I haven't really driven the car much since. So I figure replacing this one bad one is good enough. Plus the price of these have gone up so much. I think I originally paid maybe less than $10 each for these when I replaced them last time. They're up to like $15 to $16 now on Amazon and on Rock Auto and all those places. Luckily, Advanced Auto Parts locally had these for the same price as Amazon. They actually delivered it using like a roadie or an Uber type car service that delivered it. So I figured it saves me a trip down there and they leave it at my door. So I figured I'd give it a try and be lazy about it. But at least I got this now and I'm gonna throw it in there and see what's going on. All right, let's try this one more time with the new plug in there. Yeah, everything sounds normal now. I think the check engine light's still on there because I didn't clear it. So I'm gonna go ahead and clear it and see what's going on now. Under the hood, everything sounds normal. It doesn't sound out of balance and making those weird noises earlier that we were hearing. So this is a very good sign. So the check engine light's still on and it still has a historic code for the misfire. But if we look right here on the counts on this startup, I have 0 misfires shown over here. Before, when I had that misfire, it was showing like 50 or 60 of them, but now I'm showing 0. So this is a good sign. I'm gonna go ahead and clear everything and call it a day on this one. So over here, we still have the check engine light due to the historic code. I also got the 2 lean codes because I forgot to put the connection tube back into the intake, so it was bringing in unmetered air. We'll go ahead and hit the reset button down here and clear everything.
Hey guys, thanks for joining me all the way to the end of this troubleshooting video. Luckily, we found the solution. It was an easy one, which was the spark plug. So anytime you have those misfire codes and you get those P0300 codes, this is the troubleshooting steps you need to go through. You need to look at your spark plugs, you need to check your coil packs, and you just check wiring and connections around each cylinder. Usually one of those items is gonna cause the misfire. As you can tell in the video, what we did was kind of move spark plugs around, move coil packs around, and see if the problem moves from cylinder to cylinder. Luckily for us, it was only a $15 fix. It might have been my stupid mistake when I put these spark plugs in. I must not have tightened them enough, or maybe I dropped them in and I hand tightened them and I forgot to torque them down. But it looks like I found 2 of them on that side that were loose. The third one on the back cylinder was tight. Then on bank 2 off camera, I checked the one cylinder that I could get access to because it's not blocked by intake manifold. And that one wasn't completely tight either, so I had to tighten that down. I'm hoping the last 2 that I can't get to don't have any issues in the future. But I guess if they do, then I'll have to take it apart and do some cleaning of the head, do some walnut blasting, and doing a bunch of other stuff along with the video while I'm at it. If you guys found this troubleshooting and this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to your channel to stay on top of all my different videos, whether I'm working on the car, on the house, or anything in the garage, go ahead and subscribe to your channel and turn on the notifications for any time I upload a video. Remember, for all these different DIYs, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.